comes up to receive the diploma. There is a professional photographer taking photos of each graduate throughout the ceremony. Thank you for your cooperation. Students, can I get your attention? Can I see you? Students, do I have your attention? Wonderful. You get your certificates from this side. You come up from this side of the stage, your left, and go off the stage from your right. Okay? Is that cool? Each and every school will start by standing, you know, when we call the schools, all of you come up and stand on your left side of the stage together, come one by one. I ask again from the parents, if possible, not to get up or block anyone on the way to take photographs. We have a professional photographer here, and each and every student will get a photograph from this amazing ceremony. הורים, בעברית, עכשיו. לכל ההורים והאורחים, תודה שהגעתם. הטקס מצולם על ידי צלם מקצועי. אנחנו מבקשים לא לקום במהלך הטקס ולא לעזוב עד תומו, על מנת שכל אחד ואחת מהסטודנטים יוכלו לעלות בנוחות. יש לנו, כמו שאמרתי, צלם מקצועי, ואפשר לקחת תמונות גם אחר כך.
Chers diplômés, parents et invités, on vous invite à vous asseoir derrière les étudiants. On vous demande aussi de respecter, d'être respectueux tout au long de la cérémonie et de ne pas prendre des photos sur la scène. Les étudiants, on vous demande de monter, récupérer vos diplômes de ce côté-là et de retourner de l'autre côté pour récupérer vos diplômes. Il y a un photographe professionnel qui va prendre des photos tout au long de la soirée, donc on vous demande de ne pas prendre des photos sur la scène. Merci, bonne soirée.
Padres invitados, mi familia. queremos pedirles que por favor sean considerados y respetuosos durante la ceremonia y permanezcan en su lugar hasta el final de toque, hasta que todos los graduados reciban su diploma. Por favor no suban aquí al escenario para tomar fotos. Tenemos un fotógrafo profesional que va a tomar fotos. Estudiantes, suban por el lado izquierdo y bajen por el lado derecho. Por favor, quédense todos hasta el final de la ceremonia para que todos puedan recibir sus diplomas. Gracias.
Good evening. Erev Tov and Bochim Abayim. Welcome graduates, families, academic and administrative faculty, including the dedicated staff of RRIS, big hand, and guests. Tonight we are honoring the students who are graduating from the Arison School of Business, the Lauder School of Government, Diplomacy and Strategy, the Sammy Ofer School of Communications, and the School of Psychology of the Rafael Recanati International School at IDC Herzliya for their achievements during their undergraduate studies. I would like to begin by introducing the people sitting before you. Mr. Jonathan Davis, IDC Vice President for External Relations and Head of the Rafael Recanati International School. Dr. Yaron Timor, Academic Head of the Arison School of Business Administration Program. Dr. Leslie Terrace, Academic Head of the International Program for the Lauder School of Government. Dr. Karen Ayal, Academic Head of the Sammy Ofer School of Communications at the RRIS. Dr. Daniel Levy, Academic Head of the School of Psychology for the RRIS, and Aurela Lelouch on behalf of the IDC Alumni Association. My name is Rina Niger, and I'm proud to be the director of the Rafael Recanati International School. I wish to acknowledge the incredibly dedicated staff of the RRIS who interact daily with our students, providing them with a high-quality service that often goes beyond, above and beyond the call of duty. I would like to begin by inviting IDC Herzliya, Vice President for External Relations and Head of the Rafael Recanati International School, Jonathan Davis, to greet you all.
Okay, folks, I've got 3 minutes, 180 seconds here to do this. Okay, so how many students do we have from France here? I don't hear you. Okay. Who's here from Scandinavia? Okay, all right. Anyone from Germany here? Oh, good. USA, anyone? All right. South Africa? Israel? Israel, 12 points. Okay, so this is the situation. First of all, I would like to welcome Pierre Besnenu, who is the head of the Jewish community of France, who's with us here tonight. Let's have a hand for Pierre. Okay? He's our ambassador to France of the Rafael Recanati International School. I also want to actually recognize another ambassador here, Yitzhak Eldan, our good friend. Okay. Now, Rina mentioned the RRIS team. I'd like to mention Rina Niger, Mimi Laufer, Sylvia Kassoff, Stephanie Miller, Sarah Manor, Sandra Mihara, Maria Levine. Maria Levine should get, I mean, a clappy, takes you on all the Tivoli, I mean, really. Okay, Shirley Levy, Annette Bamberger, Annette Van Zeelen, Sarit Benor. And there's an honorary member of the RRIS in the row here. Her name is Ria Gilboa, because she does some of the work there, too. Unfortunately, Sylvia Berholtz could not be with us tonight for personal reasons, but we all love her and send her extremely warm regards. Okay? And now, I would just like to tell you that it's been a lot of fun having you guys around, okay, for the time that you were here. You know, we have about 1,500 students here from 86 different countries, speaking 22 different languages. They are Jews, Muslims, and Christians, and Hindus. You put all those guys together, you can have a great time, right? Great time. Okay, terrific. Now we all hope that you hit the ground running, don't we? Right, Mimi? Okay, we do, actually. Now, a lot of the folks here in the audience, you know, some of you are already serving in the IDF as soldiers in different units. So, for all of you who are, you know, we wish you the very best. Some of you are working in private companies right now who graduated from here. And some of you are working for nonprofits. And we also know that and nonprofits don't make that much money, by the way, so. Okay. And we also know that 70% of you are staying in Israel, which is nice. But there are also 30% of you who went back home and are going back home and are going to be wonderful ambassadors for the state of Israel in whatever country you happen to live in. And some of you even come from Sudan. And some of you come from Eritrea, okay? Now, not all of you are going back there right away, but hopefully when you do go back there, you'll become our ambassadors there as well, okay? The message I would like to leave you with is just try to be really good human beings, one to another. Try to be much better leaders than my generation of leaders. You can do much better than us, believe me. There's a lot to improve on. We hope that you learned something about leadership here. We hope that you learned something about initiative here. We hope you learned something about creativity here. Hopefully you learned something about independence here. And wherever you go, show entrepreneurship, show that initiative, and it can be social entrepreneurship, it can be business entrepreneurship, any kind of entrepreneurship where you can help people, and believe in the philosophy of Professor Reichman, which is liberty and responsibility. First of all, don't take for granted your democracy, your liberty, your pluralism, the right of women to be part of an egalitarian society, the right of gay people to live amongst us, the right of every single person in society to have that liberty. And at the same time, remember to be responsible for those in society who don't have what you have, who didn't get the same breaks that you got. And that's really the special message of the State of Israel. It's a very, very special democracy. We cherish democracy because we see some of the regimes around us who aren't all that democratic. I won't mention all of the non-democratic regimes around us, but you, if you read the newspaper, you can figure it out, okay? So be thankful for what you have. Be thankful for your families who were so kind to you while you were here. Now I would like all of the students to please rise. All of the students to please rise. I'm not gonna ask you to throw your caps in the air again. It's too much of a balagan. But what I am gonna do, I'm gonna ask everyone here for an ovation. Let's have a big clap for all of you, okay? Now what I would like you to do, this is gonna be a very, very difficult exercise, and if you can figure this out, then the Council for Higher Education actually certifies your degrees. I'd like you to turn around and face your parents, or your spouses, or your kids, or anyone who helped you. And I want the students here to clap for you, okay? Okay, because without your parents, and without your spouses, we wouldn't be anywhere, okay? And Daniel Levy's here, he believes in positive psychology, so I hope that this exercise of synergy assisted all of us. Thank you, my 3 minutes are up. I'm out of here. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Jonathan, for your inspiring words. With great pride, I will now introduce the students who will speak on behalf of the graduating class. These are honor students who have consistently been at the top of their class. On behalf of the Arison School of Business, Nir Bardea.
Benjamin Franklin said, write something worth reading or do something worth writing about. After reading to myself the first draft of this speech, it struck me that I have yet to do either, which is a scary thought considering how time flies. Like our time here, 3 years of investing in ourselves, of our fantastic faculty investing in us, building our education, strengthening our values. We belong to a very small and extremely fortunate group. In a world in which 26% of the adult population are illiterate, in a country where only 6 out of 10 capable potential workers are interested in having a job, in a country where every third child is born into poverty, we must acknowledge that with this good fortune comes a responsibility. A responsibility to choose curiosity over ignorance. Leadership over blind following. Our responsibility to choose activism over passivism. The final most important responsibility is to maintain and increase the Israeli advantage in this growingly competitive global race. I just crossed the halfway mark of my MBA abroad. Surrounded by our peers from around the world, I promise you, our generation graduating today from Seoul's National University, Shriram College of New Delhi, or the Holt International School in Dubai, they are not waiting for us. Many of them are already doing things that others will soon be writing about. So look around, consider the competitive landscape and the socioeconomic context that surround us, and now think about how lucky we are. It's our time to take action, to find what's important to us, and to get involved. Prime Minister Ben-Gurion said, "Moledet ei efshar liknot bekesef o likbosh bechelev. Tzich litzor ota biyozma uvezat apenu." On behalf of my class, I'd like to thank the IDC and all its components, the faculty, administration, and finally the students and our families. I know we'll make you all proud. תודה רבה.
Adam Brozo will speak on behalf of the Lauder School of Government.
Go, Adam!
Facebook cover photo. So, classmates of 2012, well, that was easy. I mean, we did it. It's over. A few more speeches and formalities, and we can all get on with the rest of our lives. I know that our family and friends have been patient enough already. And even after all this time, I have to say, I still don't really know how to thank the IDC staff and faculty who've made us what we are today. I mean, their hard work introduced us to the world of government, to the decision makers who comprise it, give us the chance that we have today, and I really don't know how to say it more sincerely than that, so I won't try. But before we go, I've been asked to speak on behalf of at least my class, which is a little ironic. First of all, because I'm a high school dropout. I never really finished high school, so this is my first graduation, and I'm not entirely sure how these things are supposed to work, which probably explains why my speech had to undergo 9 different revisions until the version we've got here, and it's not a joke. But second of all, there's also the idea of representing anyone other than myself, which is challenging enough, since I'm limited by the narrowness of my experience to having been only me. But today, I have to represent my entire class, which is one of the most diverse and unique group of people, that I've ever met, and I really do mean that. And I'm somehow expected to speak for all of us up here wearing a Liberace's nightgown, so apologies in advance if I don't get it right the first time. But looking back, I do think it's kind of funny to remember the first days when we got here and trying to figure out what exactly we're supposed to do. I don't know if you guys can remember how clumsy we were. We printed out these huge tomes of readers for everything in history of the modern Middle East and globalization and on. And we were all so sure that we were gonna read every word on every page of every reading. And we also knew everything about anything back then. But that didn't last long. IDC was demanding, and a little further into it, we were visibly smarter. For one thing, we stopped decimating the rainforest. But for another, we also learned to work together. We learned to self-divide into summarizers, into analysts, managers who oversaw the production and distribution of our joint coursework. We even had a few self-titled provisionists. You know who you are. These are sage prophets who could predict what was going to be on a given exam. There we go. Adi, stand up so everyone can see you. Come on. Adi, I see you laughing. All right, Adi's a little bit shy. She didn't see this coming. But when things went off schedule, the class of 2012 became an intimidating lobby, bargaining for at least several years worth of extensions and a dozen summa cum laude and successful appeals, but we did all of it together. And later still, towards the end of our degree, we began specializing. Some of us were inspired by Daphne Barak's promise of a world governed by international law. Karina Kagan found a few architects willing to theorize and explain international relations. None of us left with our opinions intact from Gali Golan's course on the Arab-Israeli conflict. And one Yair, Aaron, McClanahan, Shofet, plus minus a few names and reorganized, even managed to convince a few to pursue EU studies. And those in question are no doubt relieved to see that graduation came before the disintegration of the EU. But that's all over now. We've exhausted Moshe Mol's pleas for more questions. We've mastered the CCL, we've donned our funky electric blue robes, and we've grown up. We've gotten pregnant and married. Some of us have gotten pregnant again. And though some of us now live in a sane country, not all of us have left Israel. Some of us are in the army, some are in the Knesset, some are probably still on the beaches in Tel Aviv right now. And that's really what I was trying to get at in the beginning when I said how big and diverse this class is, and it's unbelievable how radically unique and radically capable all of us are. Look, it's not comfortable standing up here, not just because of the wear, but for me to start giving advice, I don't really feel like I've done anything great or like I know anything particularly special. And I don't even know for sure what it is I'll be doing in the far future, but I'm not really worried about that because we're not all going to know what we're doing or what we want to do at any given time, and that's okay. We don't need to know, certainly not now. IDC likes to say that we're not born leaders, we learn to become them. And even though we're all kind of rolling our eyes at that motto every time we see it on the bus stations in Tel Aviv, on the flight over here two nights ago, I was reading a book about Congolese slavery. It was interesting, I promise. And one of the most remarkable things about that episode of history that claimed as many as 8 million lives was that the man who's credited with triggering its downfall was supposed to be a businessman. That's the whole reason he was there in the first place, just to make money. And it amazed me that somewhere this businessman, had learned how to lead one of the greatest international human rights movements in history. One of the most unbelievable achievements. I can't even describe to you the horrors that he had prevented. And he did all this despite himself. He was prepared to do what was right despite what he thought he was supposed to be doing. He was prepared to contradict himself. He had no idea that all his schooling and experiences were grooming him for that role, that they were all building up to there. He couldn't have known how his life would turn upside down any more than any of us can. But if we can accept that, and if we can learn to apply what we've learned from here at IDC and elsewhere to a new truth, any new truth that comes to us, as energetically as we might have defended the opposing claim just yesterday, if we can learn to accommodate our contradictions much like he did, I think we'll be all right if we just do what we feel is right. And it doesn't matter what you did before. It's really not what you did, but what you do with what you did. And that's mastering the art of losing. Nothing gets wasted. And so I'll leave you guys with one of my favorite quotes. Those of you who've been closer to me over the past 4 years will know that I've heard this 1,000 times every time I do something I'm not really supposed to. It's an American poet, Walt Whitman, and he wrote, "Do I contradict myself? Very well. Then I contradict myself. I am large. I contain multitudes." Thank you very much.
And Bambaji will speak on behalf of the Sammy Okra School of Communications.
For different reasons. Some of us came to find a handsome husband, some because of the weather, and who can blame them. Others were drawn in by the infamous annual trip to Eilat. But for many of us, we saw an exciting opportunity that goes beyond the parameters of education. It was an opportunity to put ourselves outside of our comfort zones, away from the places that we call home, in the hope of developing ourselves in a way that very few other academic institutions enable. From IDC, we walk away not just with a degree, but with a once-in-a-lifetime experience. We adjusted to a totally new way of life. We made lifelong friends from all over the world. And we made the unfamiliar familiar. We walk away today with so much more than a piece of paper, or with another line on our CV. We walk away in the knowledge that we can exceed ourselves. We walk away with a true international mindset, and where else would we have got this? We've got a real understanding and real appreciation of the world that we live in. This, I think, is the most important attribute in today's world, or as Marshall McLuhan dubbed it, the global village. See, we did this in class. For having made this opportunity a reality, on behalf of the International School of Communications, I'd like to thank the faculty. Without their support and dedication, we wouldn't be here this evening. I would like to finish with some words of wisdom for the future, wherever that may take us. And who better to quote than a man who revolutionized the modern world of communications? Steve Jobs once said to his fellow graduates, "Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. Stay hungry and stay foolish." Thank you.
Last but not least, Tamir Goldberg will speak on behalf of the School of Psychology.
Family members and friends. I'm honored to be able to speak on behalf of my fellow classmates today. Webster's Dictionary defines a graduation speech as something that begins with a quote from Webster's Dictionary and ends with a quote from some famous person. So we got one out of the way, we'll see how we go with number two. But seriously, when I stepped onto this campus 4 years ago, I had no idea what to expect. Not from myself and not from the school. I must say that my concerns were laid to rest fairly quickly. Even during orientation week, when I met all these wonderful people that I've come to know as my friends. It's you guys, or should I say girls, that made this time meaningful, fun, and simply awesome. Thank you all for being such good friends, and making sure that there was always someone to hang out with on the grass at any given time of the day. If I had any worries left when school actually began, those two were laid to rest quickly. Mostly because of all the free beer and energy drinks that they handed out, but also because we realized how easy it was to speak to our faculty. I'm amazed at the fact that we could just knock on our dean's door and say, "Hey Mario, I have a question," or that we could speak to our professors without any barriers or pretenses. I think a quote from Daniel Levy, who by the way can make a Golgi apparatus and microtubules simply fascinating. I think that sums it up the best. The last time I saw Daniel, he just said, "Hey dude, how's it going?" And we never took this openness for granted. You know, when we speak to students from other schools around the world or in other countries, they find it hard for them to get time with their professors, let alone the head of their program or their dean. And now, that's the difference that embodies, I think, the IDC from other schools, and specifically the School of Psychology. Now it's time for us to take the education that we gained here and use it to become successful. To quote Ellen DeGeneres on number two, the definition of success changes. Success is to live your life with integrity and not give in to peer pressure, to be something you're not. Follow your passion and stay true to yourself. Never follow someone else's path, unless you're in the woods and you're lost and you see a path, and by all means, follow that path. Thank you.
With great pleasure, I invite to the staff for a short performance Dr. Yaron Timor of the Harrison School of Business, Dr. Leslie Terrace of the Lauder School of Government, Diplomacy and Strategy, Dr. Karen Ayal of the Sammy Ofer School of Communications, and Dr. Daniel Levy of the School of Psychology.
Hi, guys. So, I think that Leslie, Karen, and Yaron and I are almost as happy as you are about this occasion, because we're so glad to hear about the nice things that you have to say about your education. We also want to say that the time that we were able to spend teaching you and listening to you was no less pleasurable for us than these years have been for you. So as our way of saying thank you to you for these wonderful years that we've spent together, we've got a little song for you guys. So, Maestro, hit it.
Thank you. But no matter what you do, you know what we say is true. You'll remember IDC always.
Until semesters pass and makeup classes done.
Always.
Until the grades are all submitted one by one.
Always. Until the projects are completed by the team.
Always.
Until the homework room is bursting at the seams.
As our students already know, it's very important to us to continue our relationship with you when you are alumni. The IDC Herzliya Alumni Association was established by IDC Herzliya's first graduates and today counts thousands of members. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I would like to invite Aurela Lelouch to speak on behalf of the Alumni Association. Aurela is an RRIS graduate of the School of Business Administration, class of 2007. Today, she is Associate and Head of Communications of BNP Paribas Israel, as well as the CEO of Lev Yam Technologies.
Well, first, thank you for warming up the audience for me. Dear alumni, good evening. I'm very pleased to congratulate you on behalf of the IDC Herzliya Alumni Association on this special day. It's your graduation day. Woo! Woo! And I want to welcome you to a warm family. A warm family that I hope you will be proud to be part of. It's the family of IDC Herzliya graduates. I'm myself a graduate of IDC Herzliya. I finished in 2007. I'm now working for the French bank BNP Paribas. And these studies at IDC did not only give me the academic skills and knowledge, they also gave me the tools, the contacts, the network, and the willing to build myself in Israel. As a French citizen, I'm very glad to see that actually 9 years ago when I started to study here, we were 11 French people, including two or three people from Switzerland and Belgium. Today you are about 250. To come to Israel and to come to study Israel, it's quite easy. But then you need to be able to stay. And IDC gives you the right tools to do so. So now, just before you embark on a new adventure and you conclude your last day as a student, I want you to know that your relationship with us is not ending at all. It's actually the beginning, as you are now part of the 12,000 IDC Herzliya graduates. On this very festive day, with a lot of congratulations and good wishes and mazal tov, I would like to tell you a very few words on the Alumni Association. The Alumni Association works to establish ongoing relationships between alumni in order to help you to develop professional contacts. And I'm very proud to say that today IDC graduates are very succeeding in reaching high professional levels. We can see IDC graduates playing an active role in business, in government, in economic, in legal, in communication, and in high-tech areas in Israel and around the world. So I invite each and every one of you to join the Alumni Association Networking Club. The club has created a project called Alumni for Alumni. It encourages the development of an active and dynamic alumni network. And developing such a network is the key to our professional success in Israel and abroad. Our potential to assist one another is great. And this potential can empower and maximize your professional opportunities and successes for each and every one of you. In addition, it's important for you to know that the association is organizing many activities, many professional and social events, and I strongly recommend you to attend and to participate and to join us in these events. I would like to add another point regarding the association, who is currently developing and promoting a very important and unique program. It's called Makom Belev. It's on behalf of needy students. IDC graduates are helping to fund scholarships for needy students who hope to study at IDC Herzliya and wish to get and benefit for a high-level education in Israel. So by donating to this important cause, you would join the circle of graduates who are donating scholarships every year and make the dreams of needy students possible. I would like just to give you one number. Since the establishment of this program in February 2009, the association raised already over 2 million shekels. So please feel free to contact us, to contact the association staff, if you need any information regarding our activities and the donating program. And last but not least, and as someone who studied here like you, I have no doubt that this wonderful place and the experience that you had here will be with you for many years. Please stay in touch with us, stay in touch with your friends, and keep on the friendship you have formed here. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I wish you all a great success for the future. Thank you for your attention.
What a privilege it is to be part of the Rafael Recanati International School family. Bringing over 1,500 students together from all over the world to study for 3 years, side by side with Israelis in Israel, in English, expresses the true meaning of Zionism and love for Israel. If you're leaving Israel, I know that IDC will always remain in your hearts. If you are staying, we can't help but think that IDC played a role in your decision to remain and become a contributing member of Israeli society. And now, for the moment you've all been waiting for, the presentation of diplomas. I would like to invite 5 very dedicated women to the stage to accomplish this task. Debbie Joel, the academic coordinator for the School of Government. Rinat Bassan, academic coordinator of the School of Communications. Yael Ramati and Einat Shor, academic coordinators of the School of Psychology. And Shiley Kately, academic coordinator for the School of Business Administration, who will call out your names and hand you your diplomas together with the academic heads of the programs. Aurela Lalouche will also present you with a gift on behalf of the Alumni Association. I also want to acknowledge Karine Katz, who is in the audience. Karine is the head of the RRIS Student Authority. Before we begin, I'd like to ask all the graduates and guests who have joined us on this evening to celebrate, to please show your respect for this occasion to other parents and guests who come from far and near to see their graduating sons and daughters, and please remain seated until the ceremony is over. Graduates, please return to your places after receiving your diploma so that the ceremony can continue in an orderly manner and your fellow graduates can receive their diplomas. I thank you in advance for your cooperation and consideration. We will begin with the Arison School of Business.
Oh, it is. I thought I thought I was. Sarah Hayat. Tommy Herman. Dror Heuser. Daniel Jacksemen. Karen Yaffe. Adam Kaplan. David Lamchut. Shlomo Levy. Moshe Lev Lipner. Daniel Markovitz. Ilan Mintz. Rebecca Mitnick. Maayan Lili Mizrahi. Eran Ohayon. Yehudit Finless Rosby. Roni Salho. Amit Schlisser. Oneg Shaked. Yuval Shalem. Per Sidikman. Tina Zilber. Yonit Soloducho. Lea Shoshan. Jeremy Spitzer. Ron Bersel. Ron Weinrad. Sophie Zemel.
Woo! Sophie!
Before we go on to the Sammy Ofer School of Communications, the Louder School of Government, the first few names that were called up, the graduates who came and got their diplomas, if you didn't get an envelope, please come back and get your envelope. We will now present the graduates of the Louder School of Government.
I would like to invite Dr. Leslie Terrace to confer the diplomas for the government students. We'll begin with students who are graduating with honors for by descending GPA. Mayan Karen, magna cum laude. Christina Furness, magna cum laude. Adam Broza, magna cum laude. Johan Levkovich, magna cum laude. We continue with students graduating with cum laude honors by descending GPA. Ella Ran, Kelly DeGroat, Zach Goldberg, Adam Kohn, Bianca Ambrosio, Ilana Messica, Marlene Jacoby, Abraham Jacobs, Lana Oshel, Sephora Torjeman, Adi Salame, Lily Scott Sigwin, Leah Ledwin, Maya Herman, Iona Berger, Katrin Alcacideza. And now we would like to invite the graduate by alphabetical order. Shiri Asher, Yonina Michal Beilin, Yosef Balzas, Crystal Baranzi, Adam Bashar, Eden Beinart, Fatima Kajes, Kenan Crow, Anthony Damski, Isabel DeYoung, Carolyn Fitucci, Avraham Forsheimel, Kenneth Gottlieb, Dylan Harris, Idan Janovic, Jacob Ingram, Johan Ironmark, Kate Elizabeth Julius, Benjamin Joseph, Helen Perez, Anat Levy, Mayan Levy, Leticia Machado, Diana Melspin, Matias Malul, Adam Moss, Daniel Nobel, Neil Polanski, Aaron Bosnell, Robert Rabinovich, Abraham Sagain, Idan Chori, Yaakov Sokol, Tova Sotolovitsky, Jenny Zeinzinger, Gabriela Tiofiel, Corey Wagner, Mandy Weiss, Josh Weisfeld, and David Vola.
And now the graduates of the Sammy Ofer School of Communications.
Graduating with a magna cum laude honor. Annie Bambaji, magna cum laude. We continue with students graduating with cum laude honors by descending GPA. Leora Daum. Bernardo Chernitsky. Shira Bauman. Shoshana Greenspan, Carmel Hollander, Zahava Las, Eli Villier, Katia Meiselman, Tal Dahan, Tia Sunt, Tamar Makaba, Gabi Gluk, Ariel Beth Shak, Talia Nicole Grace, Moria Cohen, Jimena Sulimovich, Tanya Kramer, Caroline Hannah Cohen. And now I would like to invite the graduates by alphabetical order. Alexandra Adespey. Ronnie Angel. Alexa Asher. Liora Vnit. Karen Azaria. Maya Sidney Bar Aaron, Gabriela Bar Lavi, Eitan Bar, Tamara Beitelman, Daniel Bachar, Zachary Boazis, Orly Brody, Jonathan Chaim, Bora Chernes, Eitan Cherno, Emmanuel Shemla, Diana Chernia, Moshe Cohen, Jonathan Cohen, Dan Einhorn, Karin Eldan, Noah Fartu, Gabriela Fogel, Susanna Garzon, Natasia Gerard, Ray Ralph Glaser, Ingrid Goodman, Lauren Hasek, Talia Hoffman, דניאל אישק, מרים ישראל, יונה קלימנקו, אנ קופלס, תומר קראוס, עידה לייקנגר, אבא לוין, נינוסקה לוי, ג'דה לאה ליביאן, ג'ק לונץ, ג'ון מרטיסיוס, איילת מנשה, מיטל מנשה, רועי רביב, אדוארד רוגו, דנה רוזנטל, יונתן רובין, יעקב סדובסקי, אילנה ססון, מור שמואלי, ג'ק גוטסמן, לורל שב, דניאל סיסו, שרה שטיין, יאיר טילסון, ג'וש צרפתי, זוהי וייסמן וג'ויה זלוקצובר.
Before we continue with the last school, the final school, the School of Psychology, I'd like to ask you all to please be seated. Please be seated, okay? Thank you. Now the graduates of the School of Psychology.
Magna cum laude. Shani Khalak, magna cum laude. Tamir Goldberg, magna cum laude. Tammy Daly, magna cum laude. We continue with students graduating with cum laude honors by descending GPA. Maya Duarte. Anna Sophie Fuchs. Jesse George Rottenberg. Adam Van Harden. Ninbar Shimshon. Michelle Schilling. Cynthia Kersone. Limor Alster. Liri Oved. Safira Greenberg. Hila Carolina Lazar. Tamara Barak. Avital Rivka Brooks. Dania Peta Zaks. Hila Moskovich. Nomi Winkler. Tal Danieli. And now I would like to invite the graduates by alphabetical order. Ilana Agranovich. Noor Asender. Chantal Aziza. Melissa Ben Zaken. Yekeilu Bien. Ortal Braunstein. Milane Cohen. Joel Cohen. Liad Didio. Meital Elmalem. Shelly Golan. Daniel Han. Natalie Chaim. Tal Chayut. Chantal Miriam Kalish. Maya Kessel. Adi Klein. Adina Kranz. Shoshana Krug. Reut Mordechai. Chaya Nagel. Nugit Natali Rachamim. Meir Amati. Daniel Reshef. Chava Ruta. Sabo Talmor. Francine Seidner Pasternak. Rachel Suisa. Natalie Turbati. Michal Willinger. Orly Zamir.
On behalf of the RRIS and IDC, I wish all of our graduates the best for your future, and thanks to your families for supporting and assisting you throughout the process. We know that you will bring much pride to all with your future achievements. This concludes our ceremony. Mazal tov u'batzlacha, and please drive safely. Good night.